Chala
Yamuna Tera Vedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada ki.
Yeah.
ISKCON founder Acharya Srila Prabhupada ki.
Yeah.
Nitya Lila Pravishta Om Vishnu Pad Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Sarasati Thakur Srila Prabhupada ki.
Yeah.
Ananta Koti Vaishna Vrinda ki.
Yeah.
Nam Acharya Srila Haridas Thakur ki.
Yeah.
Prem Shikaho Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadatha Shri Vasati Gaur Bhakta Vindaki Shri Shri Radha Krishna Gopa Gopinath Shyam Kund Radha Kund Kiri Govardhan Ki Vrindavan Mayapur Dham Ki Ganga Maye Yamuna Maye Ki Tulsi Maharani Bhakti Devi Ki Hari Nam Sankirtan Ki All glories to assembled devotees. All glories to assembled devotees. All glories to assembled devotees. All glories to Sri Guru, Sri Gauranga. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swamin Iti Namane. Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine. Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Desha Tarine. No. Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate 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 Vasudevaya.
Narayanam Namaskrityam.
Naram
Chaiva Narottamam.
Naram Chaiva Narottamam.
Devim Sarasatim Vyasam.
Devim Sarasatim Vyasam.
Tato Jayamudiraya.
Tato Jayamudiraya.
Nasta Prayeshu Vabhadreshu.
Nasta Prayeshu Vabhadreshu.
Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya.
Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya.
Bhagavati Uttamashloke.
Bhagavati Uttamashloke.
Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtiki.
Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtiki.
So this week, I think on Tuesday is Ekadasi, and it's also the day of Krishna speaking the Bhagavad Gita.
在即将到来的一周的周二是 Ekadasi, 而且也是 Krishna 讲述 Bhagavad Gita 的日子。
So I wanted to speak something about the glories of the Bhagavad Gita.
我想今天讲一些关于 Bhagavad Gita 博迦梵歌的荣耀。
Actually, of all the books which are published by the BBT, it's the Bhagavad Gita which is the main seller.
其实在所有 BBT 出版的书籍之中, 卖的最好的就是 Bhagavad Gita.
All over the world, here in India as well as all over the world, it's the Bhagavad Gita which is known by people a little bit.
无论是在印度还是在全世界, Bhagavad Gita都是卖的最好的书, 大家都是多多少少了解一点 Bhagavad Gita。
Bhagavad Gita is sometimes called the Bible of India.
有的时候 Bhagavad Gita被称为是印度教的圣经。
In the West, you know, the Christian countries, they have their Bible. It's common, people everywhere have a, they give away free, and the people, Christian people, they'll keep a Bible. They go to, at school, I remember at school, they would give us a Bible every year.
在西方国家有基督教，他们会免费的派发圣经。有的时候他们会给到学校里。我还记得我在上学的时候得到了一本圣经。
Every year.
每一年。
So, Bhagavad Gita is like the Bible of India.
Bhagavad Gita 就好像是印度的圣经一样。
But it tells us much more than what we would get from the Bible.
但这个要比我们从圣经之中所得到的东西要多得多。
At the same time, the Bhagavad Gita is like the primary study of the Vedic knowledge.
同时, Bhagavad Gita 还代表着对伟达知识的主要的学习。
Bhagavad Gita is just one part of the Mahabharata.
Bhagavad Gita 只是 Mahabharata 的一部分。
And Srila Vyasadeva wrote the Mahabharata for the less qualified people in society.
舍利维亚萨德是为了社会上资格不是那么高的人写的《Mahabharata》。
In Bhagavad Gita, we find Mami Partha Vayapashritya Yepishu Papayonaya Striyo Vaishas Tata Sudras Tepi Yanti Parangatim. So Lord Krishna is describing that even though people may be sinful, papayonaya means that they have sinful nature, sinful past, they have an accumulation of sins to their life, but even though they're low-born and sinful, they can be delivered by the transcendental knowledge of Bhagavad Gita.
主Krishna在梵歌中提到，如果一个人他是 Papayonaya，他出生的时候就非常的罪恶，出生非常的低贱。但是如果他能够接受这些神圣的教导的话，他也可以得到拯救。And
that Srila Vyasadeva mentioned, who are these people? It's the Sudra, the Vaishya, the women, Sudra and Vaishya, And the Dvijabandhu means the friends of the Brahman, who were born in a Brahmana family, but who had become degraded and no Brahminical qualification.
释卢亚萨德又描述了这些比较低贱的人，他们有妇女，有 Vaishya， 有 Sudra， 然后除了这些之外，还有Brahman Bandhu， 就是出生在 Brahmana 的家庭之中的人，但他们并不是真正的 Brahmana。
The Vedas are meant to be only recited by the Brahmanas, the four Vedas, which we would call the Shruti. The Shruti means the four Vedas, Rig, Sama, Yajur, Atharva. These four Vedas are the property of the Brahmanas, and the Brahmana caste are meant to recite the Vedas.
伟大经典应该只由 Brahmana 们来朗诵，因为伟大经典分为四部分 ,Sama, Yajur, 等等，这些只能够是有资格的 Brahmana 来朗诵的。
Yeah, if you go to, sometimes you can go in a big temple, Indian temple, and you'll see there's lots of Brahmins sitting around, and these Brahmanas are there to be hired to perform ritualistic ceremonies which are described in the Vedas.
有时候你们去很大的印度的庙里，可以发现有一些 Brahmana 坐在那里朗诵这些伟大经典的诗歌，因为他们是被雇来专门的去朗诵，然后举行这些仪式典礼的。
So performing these Vedic rituals is the work of the Brahmana.
举行伟大的仪式是 Brahmana 的活动。
Brahmanas are meant to do the, they're meant to worship, and worship includes things like rituals, ritualistic ceremonies. They're meant to do these things, and they're meant to teach others to do them.
Brahmana 的工作就是应该做这些仪式的典礼，不仅仅他们应该自己做，而且他们应该去教导别人也这样做。
And they're meant to recite scriptures and to teach others the scriptures.
他们也应该去阅读经典，并且教导其他的人学习经典。
This is the occupational duty of the Brahmanas.
这些是 Brahmana 的附定职责。
So what about those who are not Brahmanas? What are they meant to do? How will they become purified?
但是对于那些不是 Brahmana 的人怎么办？他们的附定职责是什么？他们怎么才能够得到净化？
They have to go to Brahmanas, and they have to hire Brahmanas to do these things for them. They have to pay them money.
他们要找 Brahmana 们，他们要去雇佣 Brahmana 们，要给 Brahmana 们付钱，让他们做这些事情。
But Srila Vyasadeva, out of his compassion for fallen souls like ourselves, he compiled the Mahabharata.
但是 Srila Vyasadeva 出于对像我们这样的堕落灵魂的怜悯之心，他编纂了 Mahabharata.
That we can hear the Mahabharata, and within the Mahabharata, there is the most valuable jewel of the Mahabharata, which is the Bhagavad Gita.
这样我们便可以聆听 Mahabharata, 而在 Mahabharata 之中有非常珍贵的一个瑰宝，那就是 Bhagavad Gita.
So Bhagavad Gita is made up on, is written by Srila Vyasadeva and covers five topics which are mentioned by Srila Prabhupada in his introduction.
Srila Vyasadeva 编纂了 Mahabharata, 其中包括了 Bhagavad Gita, 而这个 Bhagavad Gita 提到了五大主题，这是由 Srila Prabhupada 在放歌的导言之中所提到的。
There's first of all Ishwara, that there's a controller, there's a supreme controller behind this world.
首先有 Ishwara, 就是一个这个世界背后的至尊的控制者。
And then the Jiva, the living entity, that all of the living entities in this world are all spirit souls, and they're known as Jivas.
然后还有 Jiva, 就是这个世界上的所有的生物体，他们都是灵魂，他们被称为是 Jiva.
And then there is Prakriti,meaning the material nature.
还有 prakriti, 意思就是物质自然。
Material nature does not have, well, there's two kinds of prakriti. There's the inferior prakriti and the superior prakriti.
Prakriti 分两类，一种是低等的 prakriti, 还有另外的一种是高等的 prakriti.
The living entities are also prakriti, but they are superior prakriti because they have consciousness.
生物体也是 prakriti, 但是它们是属于高等的 prakriti, 因为它们具有知觉。
But the inferior prakriti means the earth, water, fire, air, ether, all the different objects of the material world.
但是低等的 prakriti 就意味着土、水、火、空气、仪态，也就是这个物质世界里的各种物品。
Our buildings,
建筑物
our motor cars,
我们的汽车
our clothes which we wear.
我们穿的衣服。
All everything which we use in this world is all made up of these elements: earth, water, fire, air, and ether.
所有在这个世界上我们运用的一切，全都是由五种元素构成的，那便是土、水、火、空气、以太。
But the superior living entities, they have consciousness, and they have also subtle bodies. They have mind, intelligence, false ego.
但是高等的这些生物，他们还有更精微的元素，他们有智性、心意和假自我。
So Prakriti is, we said there's Ishvara, Jiva, Prakriti, then there is time.
我们已经提到了有 Ishvara, 有 Prakriti, 然后还有时间。
Time is described also within the Bhagavad Gita. We want to understand time, that this is another manifestation of Lord Krishna's potency.
时间在 Bhagavad Gita 之中也有提及，这是主 Krishna 的一种能量。
And Lord Krishna, of course, shows his form of time to Arjuna on the battlefield.
当然了，在战场上 ，Krishna 向 Arjuna 展示了他的时间的这个形象。
And we are all under the control of time.
我们全都在时间的控制之下。
And then there's the fifth thing, which is karma.
还有第五件事情呢，就是 karma.
And of these five things, karma is unique in the sense that karma is not eternal. The other four things are all eternal.
在这五个项目之中 ，karma 比较特殊，是因为 karma 不是永恒的，其他的那四个项目是永恒的。
Karma can be destroyed.
Karma 可以被摧毁。
We can get rid of our karma.
我们可以消除我们的 karma。
So within the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna explains these five different topics.
所以在 Bhagavad Gita 之中，主 Krishna 解释了这五个不同的主题。
And we know the background of the Bhagavad Gita, how Lord Krishna had come on the battlefield as the chariot driver of Arjuna.
我们都知道 Bhagavad Gita 的背景是什么。Krishna 是作为 Arjuna 的战车的车夫来到战场上的。
Arjuna was brought into the battlefield at Kurukshetra along with his brothers and the Pandavas, the Pandavas together, they are fighting against the Kurus.
Arjuna 连同他的兄弟们，这些 Pandava 们一起到了战场上跟库儒们作战。
Actually, the Pandavas are also Kurus.
其实 Pandava 们也是库儒族的人。
But,Dhritarashtra distinguished the Pandavas from his own sons.
但是 Dhritarashtra 把 Pandava 们跟自己的儿子们区别了开来。
He called his own sons Kurus and he referred to the sons of Pandu as the Pandavas.
他管自己的儿子叫库儒族的人，然后管 Pandu 的儿子们叫 Pandava 们。
So they were forced to come to battle.Although the Pandavas would have preferred to avoid it, and Arjuna particularly was reluctant to participate in the battle, but there was no alternative.
他们被迫的来作战，虽然而朱呢，他们不愿意来这个战场上打仗，但是呢，他们被迫不得不来作战。
And Lord Krishna said he wasn't going to take part in the battle, but he could be, he could give his army to one side, and he would come.As a chariot driver for the other side.
而主 Krishna 说他不会参战，但是他会提供他的军队给一方，然后在另外一方呢，他可以作为战车的车夫来参与。
So Arjuna was eager to have Krishna. He didn't care about Krishna's army. He wanted to have Krishna with him.
Arjuna 非常迫切地想要得到 Krishna. 他并不在乎 Krishna 的联谊，他很渴求能够得到 Krishna 跟他在一起。
Sometimes devotees become bewildered.And become more attracted to the opulence of Krishna than to the person Krishna.
有的时候奉献者们会感觉到迷惑，受到更加的受到 Krishna 的富裕的吸引，而不是受到 Krishna 本人的吸引。
Some devotees they give more importance to having big temples and having property and having wealth and having many disciples.
有一些奉献者，他们更加的强调有非常宏大的庙宇、很多的财富、很多的门徒。
And they don't give so much importance to Krishna.
他们并不重视 Krishna.
Forget about Krishna and their relationship with Krishna.
他们忘记了 Krishna 还有自己跟 Krishna 之间的关系。
But what's really important?
但到底什么是真正重要的呢？
We want to develop that loving relationship with Krishna.
我们想发展跟 Krishna 的那种爱心的关系。
And this is brought out by Krishna himself when he describes to Arjuna why he is speaking the Bhagavad Gita to Arjuna.
这是由 Krishna 本人提出来的，他讲解了，告诉 Arjuna 为什么他要给 Arjuna 讲 Bhagavad Gita。
He tells Arjuna, you're not a Vedantist.You're not a great scholar of the Vedas, and you're not a renunciate.
他告诉 Arjuna, 你并不是一个维坦特主义者，你并不是一个大的学者，你也不是一个弃绝者。
Arjuna was married. He had 4 wives.
Arjuna 结了婚，他有4个妻子。
And Arjuna was not a Brahmana. He was a Kshatriya.
而且 Arjuna 并不是一位 Brahmana, 他是一位 Kshatriya。
So why did Krishna select Arjuna?
为什么 Krishna 要选择 Arjuna?
That Krishna wants to speak the Bhagavad Gita and he chose Arjuna to hear, to be the student. Why? What was Arjuna's qualification? Just simply one thing, that he was a devotee of Krishna.
Krishna 想去讲述 Bhagavad Gita, 但是他为什么要选择 Arjuna? 只是因为一个很简单的事实，那就是因为 Arjuna 是 Krishna 的奉献者。
You may be a great scholar, you may be a great philosopher, it doesn't mean anything.
你可能是一位非常伟大的学者，你可能是一个非常伟大的哲学家，但这个其实没有任何的意义。
But if you're a devotee of Krishna, that is something very valuable.
但如果你是 Krishna 的一位奉献者，那才是真正有价值的东西。
We see all of these so-called philosophers and scholars, big learned men or great renunciates. If they're not devotees, their lives are useless.
我们看到有很多伟大的哲学家、学者还有弃绝者，但是他们的生命是没有价值的，没有用处的。
So one of the important features of the Bhagavad Gita is that it opens the doors to spiritual life for everyone, regardless of their position.
巴格吉塔的一个重要特征便是，无论人处在什么样的处境之中，它都会给人打开灵性生活的大门。
It doesn't matter where you're coming from or what your past is.
无论你从何处来，无论你有什么样的过去。
What is important is that you're willing to surrender to Krishna and to engage in his service.
重要的是你愿意去臣服于 Krishna， 并且从事于对他的服务。
And we should also do this with faith, with love, with devotion.
而且我们应该满怀信心，充满爱心，而且充满了奉爱的这样去做。
Some people have no faith. They will say, oh, this book is just written by some man. This is not perfect. How do you know this is so much knowledge?
有的人没有信心，他们说这本书是一个人写的。你怎么知道这个书里边有这么多的知识呢？
We have to understand this Bhagavad Gita is eternal knowledge. It wasn't just spoken 5,000 years ago.
我们必须要明白到这部 Bhagavad Gita其中包含着永恒的知识，这并不仅仅是5000年之前所讲述的。
Krishna himself describes how previously he had spoken this knowledge to the sun god Vivaswan.
Krishna 本人描述说，之前他曾经向太阳神 Vivaswan 讲述过这门知识。
Some people think, oh, Bhagavad Gita, this is Indian, this is Hindu.
有的人会认为 Bhagavad Gita 这个是印度的，这是印度教的。
The sun god is not a Hindu.Why you think he's, you know, why you think it's the Hindu? Sun God is not a Hindu.
太阳神可不是一个印度教徒，你为什么认为他是一个印度教徒呢？他不是一个印度教徒。
Prabhupada went to America. He was preaching in America. He said, I'm the only Hindu. There's no other, there were so many people in the temple. None of them were Hindus. Only Prabhupada. He said, I'm the only Hindu. None of these other devotees are Hindus.
帕帕去美国，他在传播 Krishna 知觉，他说只有我一个人是印度教徒，庙里有很多的人，但是他们都不是印度教徒，只有我一个人是。
But they're all very eager to hear the Bhagavad Gita and to study the Bhagavad Gita and to re-understand this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita.
但是大家都非常迫切的想要去阅读 Bhagavad Gita， 想要去学习 Bhagavad Gita， 并且理解 Bhagavad Gita 之中的知识。
So Lord Krishna speaks the Bhagavad Gita even right now. He's in some other universe speaking the Bhagavad Gita.
主 Krishna 甚至现在都在讲述 Bhagavad Gita， 他在某一个宇宙之中正在讲 Bhagavad Gita。
Because the Bhagavad Gita is eternal knowledge.
因为 Bhagavad Gita 是永恒的知识。
And people may say, oh, this is just written by some ordinary person. Not true.
有的人可能会说这是一个普通的人写的，但那并不是真的。
First of all, it was recorded by Srila Vyasadeva himself, who is not an ordinary person, but he is a great personality. He is a representative of Lord Krishna.
首先，这是由伟大的 Vyasadeva 记载下来的。他本身就不是一个普通人，他是主 Krishna 的代表。
And Srila Vyasadeva recorded what Lord Krishna himself spoke.
Srila Vyasadeva 记载下来的是 Krishna 本人所讲述的话。
Just as Sanjay was telling Dhritarashtra everything which was going on the battlefield, because Sanjay was given the power to see the Kurukshetra battlefield and to hear everything which was being said there. In the same way, Srila Vyasadeva was also hearing it.
就像 Sanjaya， 他可以向 Dhritarashtra 讲述 Kurukshetra 战场上所发生的一切，因为他被赋予了力量，可以看到，可以听到，了解到大家所说的所有的一切。同样道理 ，Vyasadeva 也有这样的能力，他记载了 Krishna 所说过的话。
So Srila Vyasadeva included the Bhagavad Gita there within the Mahabharata.
因此 ，Srila Vyasadeva 把 Bhagavad Gita 囊括在了 Mahabharata 之中。
We should also understand that prior to the Kali Yuga, people were having very good memories. They could hear and they would remember.
我们应该记住，在卡利瑜伽之前，人们是有非常好的记忆力的，只要他们听一遍就可以记住。
We're unfortunate victims of the Kali Yuga. We have very poor memories.
不幸的是，我们全都是卡利瑜伽的牺牲品，我们有非常糟糕的记忆力。
We hear so many times, we forget.
我们听很多遍，我们还会忘。
But Srila Vyasadeva,he heard Krishna speak the Bhagavad Gita and he understood Kali Yuga is coming. I better record the whole thing, write it all down for the people in the Kali Yuga.
Srila Vyasadeva 从 Krishna 那儿听到了 Bhagavad Gita， 然后他就在想，我应该马上把所有的一切都记下来，因为 Kali Yuga 马上就要到来了，我是记下来为了所有 Kali Yuga 的人的好处。
And Srila Vyasadeva thought, Kali Yuga is coming. I don't want to stay here for the Kali Yuga. I'm going to go away and wait for the end of the Kali Yuga. He went off to the Himalayas. He's still in the Himalayas. And when the Kali Yuga is over, he will come down.
Srila Vyasadeva 就在想 Kali Yuga 要到来了，我可不想在这待着等着 Kali Yuga， 我要离开，所以他去了喜马拉雅山。他现在还在那里，等到 Kali Yuga 结束了之后，他才会再回来。
But before he went to Himalayas, he first of all wrote.This Mahabharata.
但首先他去喜马拉雅山撰写了这部 Mahabharata.
And the real purpose of the Mahabharata, the most valuable part of the Mahabharata, is this Bhagavad Gita.
而 Mahabharata 之中的最精华的部分，也就是最好的部分，那就是这部 Bhagavad Gita.
Sometimes, you know, some years ago, I remember there was a drama.It went to America, went to New York, and was on Broadway there in America. It was called the Mahabharata. And they were doing, you know, the different dramas of the Mahabharata. But Krishna, they only showed a very small part about Krishna. He wasn't the main character.
几年之前在美国纽约的百老汇，大家上演了一出戏剧，这个戏剧的名字就叫 Mahabharata. 但在那出戏里， Krishna 并不是一个主要的角色。
So, people may read the Mahabharata, they may not pick out what is really an important part there in the Mahabharata.
因此，人们可能会阅读 Mahabharata， 但是他们却不能够找到 Mahabharata 之中的精粹。
They get lost with all the dramas and the different rituals and the different things, the battle and everything which is going on, and they kind of forget about the Bhagavad Gita.
他们在看 Mahabharata 的时候就会迷失在其中的戏剧表演战争等等，他们就会忘记 Bhagavad Gita。
but actually it's really the Bhagavad Gita, which is the valuable part of the Mahabharata.
但实际上 Bhagavad Gita 才是 Mahabharata 之中最有价值的部分。
And that is why we see Bhagavad Gita has been taken from the Mahabharata, and it's shown separately, it's published individually. People read the Bhagavad Gita.
这是为什么我们看到巴格吉塔被从马哈巴尔特之中挑选出来单独的出版发行，然后很多的人都在阅读巴格吉塔。
And we want to understand how wonderful this knowledge of the Bhagavad Gita is.
而且我们想了解这个巴格吉塔的知识是多么的奇妙。
That we can bathe our minds in the wisdom of the Bhagavad Gita.
这样我们便可以让自己的心意沐浴在巴格吉塔的智慧之中。
So Krishna begins, we see in the Bhagavad Gita, it begins with some background. We hear about the battlefield and Arjuna's on the battlefield and he's very reluctant to take part in the battle because he can see so many people who he has relationships with and who he respects.
我们可以看到巴格吉塔的一开始描述了一些战争的背景。而中呢非常的勉强的去作战，因为他可以看到在战场上有很多他非常亲爱的人，他的一些亲友。
People like Bhishma, grandfather Bhishma, Drona, his teacher, Arjuna has to fight against them, he has to even kill them.
比如说有他的祖父 Bhishma, 还有他的老师 Drona, Arjuna 不仅要跟他们作战，而且他要杀了他们。
But Arjuna is fortunate because he has Lord Krishna with him.And he takes the opportunity to surrender himself to Lord Krishna. And he tells Lord Krishna, I want to be your disciple. I'm surrendering to you. Please tell me what I should do.
但是Arjuna非常的幸运，他接受 Krishna 为他的灵性导师，然后他说，我是你的门徒，请告诉我，我到底应该做什么。
And initially, Krishna's response is, oh, Arjuna, come on, we're friends. You know, I can't be your teacher. You know, It's not proper. We're friends. We're equals. How I can be your teacher?
在一开始的时候 ，Krishna 说：“哦，阿朱呢？算了吧，我怎么能成为你的老师呢？咱们是朋友，我不可能成为你的老师。”
But then, the conversation continues. Krishna sees Arjuna is determined to take shelter of Lord Krishna, and Lord Krishna begins to instruct him.
但是接着对话再继续。Krishna 可以看到 Arjuna 非常的有决心，愿意从他这里接受教导，所以 Krishna 便开始教导他。
And Lord Krishna is a perfect teacher. He begins to dismantle all Arjuna's reasons for not taking part in the battle.
Krishna 是非常好的一位老师，他分析了 Arjuna 不想去，就是说他驳斥了 Arjuna 不想去参战的所有的理由。
Lord Krishna.Has come to teach the yoga of action, not inaction. Sometimes we get the idea yoga means to stop everything, sit down and do nothing. But this is not what Krishna's teaching in the Bhagavad Gita. Krishna's speaking about action.
Krishna 教导的是行动的 yoga, 而不是不行动的 yoga. 有的时候我们会误认为 yoga 就意味着坐下来什么都不做。但实际上 Krishna 在 Bhagavad Gita 之中教导的是行动的瑜伽。
And Krishna, first of all, defeats all of Arjuna's reasons for not fighting, and he tells Arjuna, no, you have to fight, you have to do your duty, it's required. And Krishna begins to explain about karma yoga.
Krishna 先击败了 Arjuna 不想作战的全部理由，然后告诉他你必须要作战，你必须要参战。然后 Krishna 给他讲解了 Karma Yoga。
Actually, even before Karma Yoga, Krishna also talks a little bit, very briefly, about Karma Kanda that you can enjoy if you fight. You will enjoy you if you win the battle, you'll enjoy the kingdom, and if you don't win the battle, you get killed in the battle, you'll go to heaven.
而且在讲述 Karma Yoga 之前 Krishna 向 Arjuna 透露了一点点 Karma Kanda 那就是如果你去打仗你打赢了你就可以去享受这个王国如果你输了的话起码你也可以去天堂星球
So both ways you'll enjoy win or lose This is what everybody wants to enjoy So Krishna's encouraging Arjuna You will enjoy if you win You'll enjoy if you get killed You'll still enjoy
所以两个方面他都可以享受无论是赢还是输如果你赢了你可以享受你输了你仍然可以享受、
So Krishna was encouraging Arjuna first of all Karma Kanda and then Karma Yoga Karma Yoga means working
with a detached mood.
Krishna 先给 Arjuna 讲了 Karma Kanda， 然后呢，他接着给 Arjuna 讲 Karma Yoga， 也就是说用不依附的方式去活动。
Means no reactions to the work which he's doing.
这样你做的活动不会产生任何的反应。
And we worry about getting reactions. Arjuna was worried about reactions, fighting and killing people. I'll get reactions. I'll get bad karma. Oh, I don't want bad karma. I don't want to suffer. Oh, I may try to avoid the bad karma.So Krishna said, then do karma yoga, you won't get any karma.
一般人们都会想避免活动的这种反应，而Arjuna也非常的担心这个活动的反应，然后 Krishna 就告诉他，如果你这样做的话，你做 karma yoga, 你不会因为你的行动而产生任何的反应。
And then after, usually people who do karma yoga, they don't have any knowledge, they just work in a detached way, they don't know anything really.They don't know any difference, who's God, who's the Supreme, or why I'm not attached to the result, why I'm giving up the results. They just work. But then Krishna goes on to explain about Jnana Yoga.
一般人们做 Karma Yoga, 他们就只是去活动，他们不去太关心其他的细节，他们只是不依附于这个结果。但是 Krishna 继续向 Arjuna 解释什么是 Jnana Yoga。
Jnana, yeah, Jnana Yoga, knowledge. With knowledge...One should also act. Even though you have knowledge, sometimes people think, oh, I have knowledge, so I'm not going to do anything. I'll just sit and do nothing. I'll just sit and I won't do anything. That's not Krishna's teaching in the Bhagavad Gita. Rather, Krishna's teaching is action. He wants Arjuna to act, but with knowledge.
一个人即使有知识的话，他也应该去行动。有的时候人们会认为我有知识，我就不需要去行动了。但是 Krishna 告诉 Arjuna， 即使你有知识的话，你仍然应该去行动。
And act by acting with knowledge, then we will understand also that we're not actually the doer, that there's a higher personality behind everything who's really responsible for everything.
通过满怀知识的去行动，我们便认识到我们自己并不是作为者，而在整个所有的一切的背后还有另外的一个人。
And Krishna goes on to explain about the super soul contemplating the Lord in the heart as the super soul, and then he introduces also the Ashtanga Yoga process.
然后 Krishna 继续的解释，在内心之中可以去冥想超灵，而对这个超灵的冥想呢，接着 Krishna 就讲述了 Ashtanga Yoga 的程序。
But Arjuna rejects that process and said he can't do that.
但是 Arjuna 排斥了那个程序，他说他做不到。
Krishna said, well, it's possible. Of course, you need to practice.
Krishna 说这个是有可能的，当然你需要去休息，去练习。
But still, the knowledge is important.
但仍然知识是重要的。
And you have to control the mind.
而且一个人必须控制心意。
If you don't control the mind, then what kind of yogi are you? You're not a yogi at all if you don't control the mind.
如果你不去控制你的心意的话，你是什么样的一位 yogi? 如果你不控制心意，你根本不是一个瑜伽师。
We have to fix the mind on the Supreme.
我们必须要把心意专注在至尊者身上。
And with the mind fixed on the Supreme, then we should learn to act with devotion.
当我们把心意专注在至尊者身上的时候，我们应该学习如何满怀奉爱之心的去行动。
So in this way, in the first six chapters, Lord Krishna described the yoga ladder, and with the conclusion that bhakti yoga was at the top of the yoga ladder.
这样，在巴格吉塔的前六章之中 ，Krishna 描述了瑜伽阶梯，而这个瑜伽阶梯的这个顶点就是 bhakti yoga.
And one who's really a devotee, who's really doing bhakti yoga.He's also doing karma yoga and jnana yoga and jnana yoga.
如果一个人真正做到了 bhakti yoga 的话，那么实际上他也做了 karma yoga, jnana yoga, 还有 dhyana yoga.
Right, karma yoga means working in a detached manner from the results.
Karma yoga 的意思就是不依附活动的结果去行动。
And we should have knowledge. We can't just chant. We have to also read the books. We have to hear.
而且我们也应该有知识，我们并不仅仅应该去唱诵，我们应该去阅读，应该学习知识，应该去聆听。
I was reading the purport in the second canto. Prabhupada said, "It's good to chant, yes, but it's not enough. You must also read Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam."
我在读《博伽瓦坛》第二篇的要旨，其中Śrīla Prabhupāda说到，唱诵非常的好，但是你还应该去阅读《Bhagavad Gita》和《Srimad Bhagavatam》。
If we're not reading the scriptures regularly, then our chanting will not be effective.
如果我们不去经常有规律的阅读经典的话，我们的唱诵便不会有效果。
So Bhagavad Gita is the beginning of our study of the scriptures.
所以《Bhagavad Gita》是我们学习经典的开始。
We get the the basic principles of spiritual knowledge.
我们可以通过这个得到灵性知识的基本原则。
And from the, if you have a good knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, then it will help you to understand Srimad Bhagavatam.
如果我们有关于 Bhagavad Gita 的很好的知识的话，这个可以帮助我们去理解 Srimad Bhagavatam.
So then, in the middle section of the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna begins to describe about the process of Bhakti Yoga.
在 Bhagavad Gita 的中间的部分，主 Krishna 开始描述 Bhakti Yoga 的程序。
And he describes also about other people who may worship demigods, for example.
他还描述了，比如有其他的人崇拜半神人。
And he explains that the worshipping demigods is done by foolish people who are very attached to material desire.
而且他描述说，那些崇拜半神人的人是非常愚蠢的人，他们依附于他们的愿望的结果。
And whatever results they get by worshipping demigods, they have to be sanctioned by the Supreme Lord Krishna.
而实际上，通过崇拜半神人能够得到什么样的结果，这一切都必须要得到主 Krishna 的批准。
And then Krishna gives the most confidential knowledge.
然后 Krishna 给出了最机密的知识
Right in the middle of the Bhagavad Gita
就在 Bhagavad
Gita
的中间在第九章里
Krishna describes how he has very special relationships with his devotees
Krishna 描述他跟他的奉献者们之间有一种非常特殊的关系
At the same time Krishna is equal to everyone But he has a special affection for his devotees
同时的 Krishna 对所有的人都是一视同仁的但是他却对于他的奉献者青睐有加
And this is understood by how Krishna provides for his devotees how he wants to take care of them and maintain them
我们可以从 Krishna 如何的维系他的奉献者如何的去照顾他的奉献者们这一点可以看出来
He protects us and he's giving us shelter
他保护我们给我们庇护
We have to understand how merciful Lord Krishna is to anyone who renders even a little service to him.
我们应该明白到 Krishna 对于任何一个给他做出了一丁点服务的人都非常的仁慈。
And we can see examples, for example, the demon Aga, how she came to poison Lord Krishna. And Lord Krishna simply thought, oh, she wants to be my mother. Although she was coming to poison Krishna,Krishna took her as his mother and took her back to Godhead.
我们可以从 Putana 的例子之中得到启发，就像是他涂了毒药来给 Krishna 喂奶，但是 Krishna 接受了他的这一点服务，并且呢，让他提升到自己母亲的地位。
And then Lord Krishna describes the most confidential knowledge. He said, simply you have to do four things.
然后 Krishna 总结了一下这个知识说你只需要做四件事情就可以
Engage your mind in thinking of me
让你的心意想着我
Means you have to know something about Krishna
这就意味着你需要对 Krishna 有所了解
We have to know Not only, oh, he plays the flute, he has a peacock feather
我们不应该仅仅知道哦，他吹笛子他带着孔雀羽毛
Oh, he has many girlfriends
他有很多的女朋友
You have to know how he does the creation.What are his potencies?
你要了解他是如何进行的创造，他的力量都是什么。
We have to understand he has inconceivable potencies.
我们必须要明白到他有不可思议的力量。
Without understanding the fact that Krishna has inconceivable potencies, then we will never understand Krishna's lila with his confidential devotees.
如果我们不能够理解 Krishna 的不可思议的力量，那么我们永远也不能够理解 Krishna 跟他的机密奉献者之间的逍遥时光。
So Srila Prabhupada writes in Srimad Bhagavatam that unless you purified yourself, don't go beyond the first two cantos of Srimad Bhagavatam.
Srila Prabhupada 说，除非你让自己得到了净化，否则的话，你的阅读不应该超过 Srimad Bhagavatam 的第一篇和第二篇。
First.Understand the Bhagavad Gita and the first two cantos of Srimad Bhagavatam carefully. That will purify us. Then you can go on to the other, higher levels of Srimad Bhagavatam.
首先认认真真的学习巴格的 Gita 还有 Srimad Bhagavatam 他们的前两篇，然后我们理解了之后再可以去看 Srimad Bhagavatam 他们的更高级的篇章。
And then Lord Krishna then well Arjuna wants to he's heard the most confidential knowledge from Lord Krishna but then he asks Lord Krishna how can I think of youin this world, when I see everything in this world, how can I remember you? How can, because you want me to think of you, I use my mind to think of you, how can I remember you and everything that's going on, taking place in this world?
在 Arjuna 从 Krishna 那里聆听到了最机密的知识之后呢，他就问 Krishna 说，当我在这个世界上生活的时候，我看到万事万物，我如何能够想起你？因为 Krishna 让他一直想着他。所以他就说我在看到所有的这些事物的时候如何能够想起你
And so then Lord Krishna speaks chapter 10 of the Bhagavad Gita which is called Vibhuti Yoga
然后 Krishna 便向阿中的讲述了 Bhagavad Gita 的第十章这个名字叫做 Vibhuti Yoga
meaning the opulences Vibhuti means opulences of the absolute Krishna's describing his opulences how he'spervading and supporting this entire creation.
Vibhuti 的意思就是绝对者的赋予 Krishna 向 Arjuna 描述他如何通过他的这些赋予遍及整个的创造
How is he pervading and supporting this entire creation? By a single fragment of himself, by the super soul.
他如何通过自己的赋予的一个小的火花通过超灵便遍及维系整个的宇宙万物
And of course so manyfeatures were described by Krishna. He described about the taste in water, in the different elements, the taste in water, the light of the sun and the moon, the heat in fire, ability in man, so many different aspects of his inconceivable opulence.
当然 Krishna 向 Arjuna 描述了很多的方面比如说它是水的味道而且呢他还提到它是以太中的声音人中的能力等等 Krishna 有很多的这些富裕的展示还有不同的元素
Flowing rivers, I am the Ganges
在流淌的河流之中我是恒河
Of mountains, I am Meru
在山峦之中我是梅如山
Of immovable things, I am the Himalaya
在不移动的事物之中我是喜马拉雅山
Of beasts, I am the lion
在走兽之中我是狮子、
So many different ways Lord Krishna describes, I think more than 80 different features Krishna mentions to Arjuna in the 10th chapter.
一共在第十章里呢我想 Krishna 一共向 Arjuna 描述了大概有80种不同的特征。
But then Krishna says to Arjuna, what need is there for all this detailed knowledge, Arjuna? There's no need for all this detailed knowledge.
然后 Krishna 对 Arjuna 说 Arjuna 得到这些详细的知识有什么用处呢没有必要去了解这些细节
With a single fragment of myself I pervade and support the entire creation
只是通过我的辉煌的一闪我便保护并且维系了整个的创造
So then the next chapter Arjuna he's heard about Krishna's opulences So he says to Krishna he saidYou know, you've told me about it, but it would be good if you could also show it to me, because that will really prove that you're the Supreme Personality of God.
在聆听过了 Krishna 的赋予之后，在下一章里，Arjuna 就跟 Krishna 说，听到了你的这些赋予之后非常的好，但是最好我还是能够亲眼的看一下，你向我展示一下你的赋予。
So then Krishna's going to show Arjuna the Vishwarup, the universal form.
这样 Krishna 就要向 Arjuna 展示他的 Vishwarup 宇宙形体
This is a challenge to the, all the atheists and the non-devotees that they can that if they claim that they are actually equal to Krishna or their God then let them also show their universal form
其实这是对无神论者以及非奉献者的一个挑战如果他们声称自己是神的话那么他们就应该展示自己的宇宙形体
So Krishna shows the universal form. He shows Arjuna the Kala Rup, the form of time. He shows Arjuna his forearm form. And then Arjuna said, no, I just want to see you in your original form. And Krishna comes back to his two-arm form.
Krishna 向 Arjuna 展示了他的 Visual Roop 宇宙形体，然后他向他展示了他的 Color Roop 他的时间的形体，最后他向他展示了四臂的形体。 Arjuna 说不不不，我还是愿意看到你原本的形象。于是 Krishna 又恢复了他原来的两臂的形象。
So by showing these different forms, Krishna was establishing that he is the source, that all of these other forms, they are subordinate to his original form, which is originally the two-arm form.
Krishna 展示所有的这一切，就是为了确立所有其他的那些形象的根源都是他的这个两臂的形象。
So then in chapter 12, then Arjuna wants to know what's better, what's more pleasing to Krishna? Is it more pleasing for us to worship you in your personal form or to worship you in your feature as the all-pervading energy?
在第十二章之中呢，阿朱呢就问 Krishna， 到底做什么才能够更加的取悦你？是崇拜你的个人的这种形象，还是说崇拜你的这种无所不在的这种能量的这种方面
？And then Krishna explains to Arjuna that, oh, much better you think of me in my personal form.
然后 Krishna 告诉阿朱呢说，最好你还是想着我的这种个人的形象，
And then
人格的形象。
In the 12th chapter, Lord Krishna describes toUs as well as to Arjuna, that if we, you know, it's very difficult to think of Krishna without deviation, to have the mind totally fixed on Krishna at every moment and not forget him. So what can we do if we can't do that?
在第十二章之中，阿朱呢也问了 Krishna 另外的一个问题，也就是说毫不绝无旁骛的去冥想着 Krishna 是很困难的一件事情。我们如何才能够做到这一点
？So then Krishna said.You can't do that. Then try to practice the regulative principles of Bhakti Yoga.
Krishna 说，如果你做不到那样的话，那你就努力的去修习 Bhakti Yoga 的原则。
And by doing that, you develop a desire to attain me.
通过这样做，你便可以发展出一种达到我的愿望。
We should understand what it means to practice the regulative principles of Bhakti Yoga.
我们必须要明白到修习 Bhakti Yoga 的原则到底是什么意思。
It doesn't just mean, oh, four regulated principles, no meat, fish and eggs, no gambling, no intoxication, no illicit sex. No, that is for all civilized people.
那并不仅仅是遵守四项规范原则，哦，我不吃鱼肉蛋，不服用麻醉品，不去赌博，不做非法性行为。其实这个是对于所有文明教养的人来说都是应该做到的一个标准。
So what are the regulated principles of Bhakti Yoga?
那么 Bhakti Yoga 的规范原则到底是什么
？Wake up early in the morning.
清晨早起。
Take bath, then put tilak on your body, then chant, worship the deity, go to Mangal Arati, chant and dance, then chant Japa, hear Srimad Bhagavatam, then cook for Krishna, offer your food to Krishna, like that. This is Bhakti Yoga. This is devotional service.
我们沐浴早起之后，涂上提拉克，然后我们开始崇拜 Krishna。我们去庙里参加 Mangala Arati， 我们去唱歌跳舞，之后我们做 Japa， 之后我们聆听 Srimad Bhagavatam， 再之后我们可以做饭，然后供奉给 Krishna。所以这才是 Bhakti Yoga 的规范原则。
That's difficult for people.
这对于人们而言很困难。
So what if we can't do that?
那我们这个也做不到怎么办
？Then do Karma Yoga. Try to work for me.Offer the results of your work for me.
那我们就做 Karma Yoga， 也就是说你去努力的工作，然后把工作的结果供奉给我。
Just like devotees, there some of people most we're here we're doing full-time devotion, but there are other people who are not able to be full-time in devotional service, so they work for Krishna and they can contribute some of their hard-earned money for the service of Krishna.
在这里我们有一些奉献者是全职奉献者，但是还有其他的一些人，他们并不是全职的，所以他们可以工作，然后把自己辛辛苦苦挣来的钱供奉给 Krishna。
Just like people are donating to build the temple of the Vedic planetarium, and people are donating for book distribution, they're donating for food for life.
就像人们捐款去盖伟大天文馆的新庙，人们可以捐款去派书，人们还可以捐款去支持生命灵粮。
And so this is all purifying for them because they're working, they're earning, so they can sacrifice some portion of their earnings for the service of Krishna.
这可以非常的净化他们，因为这些人他们努力的在工作，挣一些钱，他们可以把挣钱的一部分用来对 Krishna 做服务。
And in this way they get purified.
这样他们便可以得到净化。
And gradually they'll take up Bhakti Yoga.
逐渐的他们便可以接受 Bhakti Yoga.
And what if they can't do karma yoga? They can't work for Krishna.
但是如果他们连 karma yoga 也做不到，没有办法为 Krishna 而工作怎么办？
Sometimes the family members will not allow. Don't give anything to Hare Krishna.
有的时候家庭成员不允许你去给东西，就是说你不要给 Hare Krishna 任何东西。
Okay, then give to some other people.
好吧，那就给别人吧。
That it's not spiritual, but at least it will help you to be detached.
那个并不是灵性的，但是起码可以帮助你不依附。
So like this, Krishna is explaining to Arjuna and explaining to all of us different levels of practicing bhakti yoga.
所以 Krishna 在向 Arjuna 其实也是在向我们所有的人解释，在修习 bhakti yoga 的方面有不同的层面。
Actually, Bhagavad Gita is not just speaking about bhakti yoga, but it's speaking about many different kinds of yoga. We've got karma yoga and jnana yoga and astanga yoga. You've got so many different levels of yoga.
其实巴格吉塔之中并不仅仅提到了 Bhakti Yoga， 其中也提到了 Karma Yoga、Jnana Yoga， 还有 Astanga Yoga， 有各种不同的 Yoga。
So this is why the Bhagavad Gita is so popular. It's so nice for people to read that everyone can get some education from it.
这是为什么巴格吉塔特别好，这么受欢迎，每个人都可以读书，然后从中得到一些教育的意义。
And people say, "Oh, this is just written by some man," but There's no fault in the teachings of the Bhagavad Gita. Everything explained there is perfect knowledge.
有的人说，哦，这本书是一个人写的，但实际上呢，这本书是非常完美的，其中记载的一切都是完美的知识。
You study chemistry, you study physics, you study this and that at school. Everything changes in course of time.All the different sciences and the biology and botany and all their understandings, they're all changing every year. They have to re-edit, rewrite the books and give new knowledge.
如果你去学习化学、学习物理，你在学校里学这个、学那个，你会发现这些知识不断的在改变。比如一些生物学、一些植物学，每一年他们都要重新的编辑这个书籍，然后你才能够得到最新的知识。
But Bhagavad Gita is eternal knowledge.
但是巴格吉塔是永恒的知识。
Different philosophers, they have their different theories, different rishis and great sages, they're all coming up with different theories and speculations.
不同的哲学家有他们不同的理论，还有不同的 rishi, 不同的这些圣人们，他们都会得出自己的结论，都有自己的一套理论。
But we can get the highest truth from the Bhagavad Gita.
但是我们只可以从巴格吉塔之中得到最高的真理。
Nobody can defeat the knowledge of the Bhagavad Gita.
没有人能够击败巴格吉塔之中的知识。
Nobody can say, "Oh, this is not right."
没有人能够说，哦，这个是不对的。
So this is why the Bhagavad Gita is so important for people, and why it's so much read all over the world.
这是为什么巴格吉塔对人们而言非常的重要，为什么在广泛的全世界都有人在读巴格吉塔。
So on Tuesday, it's the day of the Krishna speaking the Bhagavad Gita, and it's customary devotees to try to read the whole Bhagavad Gita that day.
周二就是 Krishna 讲述巴格吉塔的日子，而且大家有一个习俗，在那一天会朗诵整部的巴格吉塔。
You can chant all the Sanskrit if you like.
如果你们愿意的话，可以唱诵所有的梵文诗节。
The nice exercise.
很好的练习。
Okay, any questions?
好，有什么问题吗？
Yes.
非常感觉您今天讲大家非常非常非常的对我有帮助，也非常感兴趣。我想我会更喜欢。这个月月都在梵歌，也更愿意和别人分享佛的梵歌。然后我在阅读到第四章，十二世界的时候，有两个词不太明白那个意思，一个是神人同行，一个是兽行神论。
She's asking a question from Bhagavad Gita, chapter 4, verse 12.
These two words.
Oh. Ye yet curiously enough, there are many human leaders who are worshipped by foolish men under the misunderstanding of anthropomorphism or zoomorphism.
Yeah.
No, I don't understand the meaning.
Anthropomorphism is that God is made in the image of man.
第一个词的意思是说神是按照人的形象来造的。
And zoomorphism is that God is made in the image of animals.
然后第二个词的意思是按照动物的形象来就是造的神。
Like we have Varaha and Narsinga and Matsya, Kurma, you know, so we've taken from these species, we've taken and we make God like that, that this is God.
比如我们有 Varaha, 有 Matsya, 有 Kurma, 然后我们把这些形象接受了之后去造一个神，我们说神是按照动物的形象造的。
And because we have this body, we're humans, and we think so God, he must be like us.
然后因为我们有这样的形体，我们是一个人的样子，我们就觉得神肯定也是这个样子的。
So we are imposing the form of God on, by our own thinking, by what we see, we're...God must be like this.
我们是把自己的意愿强加在神身上，我们觉得我们是什么样子的，我们看到了什么，那么神也应该是这个样子的。
But we should understand it's God, the Supreme Lord Himself. He is the source of all the forms.
但是我们应该明白到神本人，他是所有一切形象的源头。
It's not that God has a human form, a two-armed form, because we have two-armed forms, but we have two-armed forms because He has two arms.
不是因为我们有一个两臂的形象，所以神才会有一个两臂的形象，而是说因为神有一个两臂的形象，所以我们才会有一个两臂的形象。
We want to be like Him. We want to be God. We've come here to this world to be the supreme.
我们想变得跟他一样，我们来到这个世界上想成为至尊者。
We are the sample God.
我们是神的模型。
Example, you know, we're not the real God.
我们是小小的模型。
We're the imitation God.
我们不是真正的神，我们是
神的模仿。But we're thinking we're God.
但是我们认为我们自己是神
so we've got a form,
所以我们有一个形象
which is similar to his.
这个跟他非常类似
not that he is a form because we have this form so he has that form
不是因为我们有这个形象所以他才有他的那个形象
okay. Yes, Mataji
我想问为什么Arjuna 想让 Krishna 去展示他绝对的富裕以及阿朱呢为什么要让 Krishna 去展示他的宇宙形体这两个之间的 有什么不同的用意不同的用意一个是展示他的宇宙形体一个是展示他绝对的富裕分别是想他的用意是什么有什么区别
The relationship between his opulences and the Vishwarupa.
What is Arjuna's purpose of requesting Krishna to show his opulence and his universal form?
What's the difference?
Well, Krishna first of all spoke his opulences, right?
Krishna 首先讲述了他的富裕，对吗？
He told. He said, "I am the taste and water. I am the light of the sun and moon. I am the." He told all of these things. So then Arjuna said.You've spoken it. He said, I want to see it. I don't just want a philosophical understanding. I want to actually see it in reality. So then Krishna shows the universal form.
Because Krishna 首先先告诉了 Arjuna, 他说我是水的味道，我是太阳光、月亮光，我是人中的才能等等。但是呢 ,Arjuna 说你不仅仅告诉我，你应该展示一下。所以 Krishna 向 Arjuna 展示了他的宇宙形体。
Because the Arjuna want to see the Krishna's opulence, so Krishna gave.
Arjuna believes in Krishna. Arjuna knows who Krishna is. He's already said Krishna is the supreme. He said, "Param Brahm, Param Dham, Pavitram, Paramam Bhavan." In the 10th chapter, right? He said, "You are the supreme Brahman, the supreme abode." And he said, "All the great sages like Asita and Devala and Vyasa and Narada, they all accept you as the supreme." He said, "I also accept you as the supreme." But Arjuna wants Krishna to show the universal form to establish the principle that somebody else is coming to say they're God. Okay, prove it. You show the universal form. Arjuna wants Krishna to establish this standard. What is it? You know, if you're actually God, you have to prove it. You have to show that universal form.
尔朱呢自己他已经相信 Krishna 是至尊的 Brahman， 比如说在第十章之中他谈到 Krishna 是 part of Brahman， 他是至尊的居所等等。他还提到像那些伟大的圣人 Asita, Devala, Vyasa, Narada， 他们也都说 Krishna 是至尊人格守神。但是呢尔朱呢想确立一个标准，这样今后如果有人声称自己是神的话，他们必须要展示，你要展示你的富裕，展示你的宇宙形体，证明你是神。所以尔朱呢这样做的目的是为了设立一个标准，一个原则。
It's easy to speak, right?
I'm God.
说起来很容易，我是神。
Okay. Show me your universal form.
好吧，给我看看你的宇宙形体。
Oh, you have to have divine eyes.
哦，你得有神圣的眼睛才能看见。
Well, you're God. Give me divine eyes.
那你是神，你给我神圣的眼睛吧。
Krishna gave Arjuna divine eyes to see the universal form.
Krishna 给了 Arjuna 神圣的眼睛去看他的宇宙形体。
So, Arjuna wants to establish a criterion for somebody establishing, for what is the actual standard for someone to actually say they're God.
Arjuna 其实是想设立一种标准，这个范畴就是如果有人想声称自己是神的话，他应该表现出什么样的标准来。
You can't just make a claim. You can't just speak philosophy.
你不能仅仅是声称，仅仅是讲哲学。
That's not enough.
那是不够的。
People want to see you really God, show it.
我们想看你真的是什么，给我们展示一下。
So Krishna showed Vishwarupa.
所以 Krishna 展示了他的 Vishwarupa.
But it's not pleasing to a devotee.
但是对于奉献者而言，不是那么悦人的。
Well, non-devotees, they want to see that. They think they like this thing. They want to see this universal form. Because they think of God in terms of the universe.
那些非奉献者他们很喜欢，他们愿意看这样的宇宙的形体，因为他们是按照宇宙的这个角度来看待神的。
They don't have the ability, they don't have the purity to see the transcendental form of the Supreme Lord.
他们还没有达到那种纯净的程度，能够看到主的超然的人格的形象。
So they can see the universal form. They see God in the universe.
所以他们只能够去看宇宙形体，他们在宇宙之中看到神。
That is called pantheism.
这个就叫做泛神论。
You see the world, see everything in the world in relation to God.
看这个世界，看这个世界上所有的一切都跟神有关系。
You know, the trees are like hairs on the body of the Lord.
树木就好像是主身上的毛发。
The clouds are like the hair on the head of the Lord.
云朵就好像是主头上的头发。
The rivers are like veins on the body of the Lord.
河流就好像是主的这种血脉。
The sun is the eyes of the Lord.
太阳好比是主的眼睛。
And the moon is the mind.
而月亮是心意。
All different aspects of material nature, they're all there within the universal form.
物质自然的方方面面全都存在于主的宇宙形体之内。
And if you contemplate that universal form, it's purifying because you see everything in the world in relation to God.
那如果你去冥想主的宇宙形体的话，这个其实是非常净化人的，是因为你看到所有的一切的存在都跟主有关系。
But it's important that when you do that, you have the mood of service. If you don't have that mood of service, then it's useless.
但重要的是当你这么做的时候应该有服务的态度，如果你没有服务的态度的话，你这样做是徒劳无功的。
So it's very important to get people to do service because that's how they get purified.
所以让人们做服务是非常重要的，这是他们如何得到净化的方法。
Gurude, 想问一个问题，就是在开始的时候您讲到我们越来越受到有一些可能受到 Krishna 的这种富裕的能量的吸引，比如说您提到的受到宏大的庙宇以及越来越多追随者还有那些富裕性，那么我们如何更专注于能够和 Krishna 本人建立关系，到底哪一些是外在的，哪一些是内在的？
Well, we have to understand Krishna from the beginning.
我们必须要从开始来理解 Krishna.
Just like theWe said you should study the Bhagavad Gita and we hear from Krishna's basic knowledge of the different, only speaking about the Ishvara and the Jiva and Prakriti and all these things. So this is a good introduction.
我们要从开始学起，比如说我们学习巴格吉塔，我们先要学习什么是 Ishvara， 什么是 Prakriti， 什么是这些 Jiva， 就是这是一个很好的开始介绍。
But、you don't want to jump into the internal potency of Krishna without first of all understanding more about Krishna's inconceivable potency.
但是在你了解到 Krishna 的不可思议的力量之前，不要先去跳到这个 Krishna 的内在力量之中。
And that's whythings like Rasa Lila come way up in the 10th canto.
这是为什么 Rasa Lila 出现在 Srimad Bhagavatam 的第十篇。
And even Krishna picking up the Govardhan Hill, these things all come later in, up in the 10th canto. To understand Krishna's Lilas and pastimes there in Vrindavan, they're very confidential. We will misunderstand them if we've not properly understood his external feature.
而且 Krishna 举起勾尔丹山的这个逍遥时光也是出现在瓦坛的后半部分，因为如果我们要是没有开始去理解它的这些能量的话，那么没有办法去了解它的机密的内在的逍遥时光。
That's why we say meditating on Krishna, you meditate first on his lotus feet.
所以我们说在冥想 Krishna 的时候，首先冥想他的莲花足。
You have to hear about creation.
你必须要先聆听创造。
How does this world come into existence?
这个世界是如何存在的。
So this is actually a very... But even to understand creation,If you haven't understood the Bhagavad Gita, if you haven't gone through the Bhagavad Gita, it would be very difficult for people.
但即使是为了理解创造，如果你连巴格吉塔都没有读过的话，那人们是很难理解的。Guru Maharaj, I think his question is, at the beginning of your lecture, you mentioned sometimes we were attracted by some external features, like we are attracted by big temples, a lot of followers, opulence, wealth.Then how can we really concentrate on how to cultivate our loving relationship with Krishna and not be attracted by the external features?
Oh, well, not just Krishna's external feature and internal features. But, well, yeah, it's easy to get influenced by these things.
是的，很容易受到这些东西的影响。
We have to try to...keep a check on our mind and senses.
我们一直要努力地去观察我们的心意和感官。
Understanding the opulence of the material world to be temporary.
要理解到这个物质世界的富裕是短暂的。
We should think, what is the real opulence of the world?
我们应该想一想这个世界的真正的富裕是什么。
What is really eternal?
到底什么是永恒的？
So whatever devotional service we can do, that's eternal benefit.
无论我们能够做什么样的奉献服务，这个可以给我们带来永恒的好处。
Don't get bewildered by the external features.
不要被那些外在的特征所迷惑。
Srila Prabhupada saw after his spiritual master departed from the world.Prabhupada saw how his godbrothers were all anxious to get the property and the assets.
Srila Prabhupada, 在他的灵性导师隐居之后，他看到自己的灵性兄弟们非常迫切地想要得到那些物质的财产。
But Prabhupada just focused on trying to preach.
但是 Prabhupada 只专注在传播上。
And of course, at the same time, he was writing his books.
同时他还在写书。
But...You know, without thinking about his material circumstances, he went off to America.
但是没有太考虑他自己的情况，他去了美国。
And then he came back to India.
然后他就回到了印度。
And tried to did his want to establish also Krishna consciousness here.
他也努力地在这里确立 Krishna 知觉。
So Prabhupada just depended on Krishna. He didn't worry about these features.
帕帕只依靠 Krishna, 他并不担心这些特征。
He didn't worry if there was a lot of opulence or if there was no opulence. He didn't worry how many people were there.
他并不担心有财富还是没有财富，他也不担心有多少人。
Prabhupada came. I remember Prabhupada coming in London. We were about 20 people, all young, very young. We didn't know anything.
帕帕，我还记得他来了伦敦，当时我们有大概20个人，我们非常的年轻，什么都不知道。
But Prabhupada came there, spent days with us, preached to us, encouraged us.
但是帕帕来了之后给我们讲课，跟我们在一起鼓励我们。
And he understood that in time, gradually, things will develop.
他知道随着时间的发展，所有的一切会慢慢的去也得到发展。
Prabhupada was just surrendered to Krishna.
帕帕他臣服于 Krishna.
So it's all about surrender. You've got to be surrendered. You've got to really think.What does Krishna want?
这全都是跟臣服有关的。你必须要臣服于 Krishna， 你必须要知道 Krishna 想要的是什么。
You have to control your mind and not get too ambitious for material facilities.
你必须要控制自己的心意，不要太去有野心的想着要得到那些物质的便利条件。
Just try to get a good foundation to Krishna consciousness.
努力的为自己确立一个 Krishna 知觉的良好的基础。
Understand.The philosophy carefully.
仔细地理解这门哲学。
And don't get carried away by the material energy.
不要因为物质能量而随波逐流。
Understand how temporary this whole world is.
要了解到这个物质世界所有的一切是多么的短暂。
And how we're all very insignificant in the eyes of Krishna.
而我们所有的人在 Krishna 的眼中是多么的微不足道。
Okay.So we'll have more kirtan.
好吧，我们现在做更多的 kirtan.
Gadadhar is here. Mm-hmm. Can he come?
Okay, Srila Prabhupada ki
Jai.